Hello, can you hear me? I think I had the mic muted. Welcome, everybody. Let me know if you can see me and hear me now. This is my first time streaming on YouTube, working out the kinks. All right. Well, I am coloring some Arclan pages today. Thanks for joining, all that are watching. You can see here, this is the last page that I did. So this is similar to what we're going to be coloring today. What I'm going to be coloring today. Same location as this bottom here. And then moving into some colorful sewers, which I'm looking forward to starting to color. So, I've got this page, and this page. We probably won't get to all three, but I have those ready. And, well, yeah, we'll dive in here. So this is the bar, the skullduggery that you can see on the top panel. Middle panel is the same room as in this bottom, the steam room basement. So I'm going to be pulling a lot of the same colors. Just make sure that the stream is working. Right, I think it's all working. Again, this is my first time. It's my first time. It's my first day. Can I pull some colors from this? Real weird for a little bit. There's our base color. gonna put in some flats. They jump around sometimes. If I'm looking at the same color in a lot of different areas, I'll put that color where it needs to be. Then I'll have to go back to that color. So yeah, feel free to ask any questions. I'm keeping an eye on the chat window here. If I've done everything right, I should be able to see any questions or comments as they come up. I'm just going to keep working away. And hopefully this is entertaining to someone. But if it's not, at least I'm getting some work done. And if you're wondering why I look like some kind of distracted bird, constantly looking up and down, it's because I'm working off of a tablet, which you are seeing. And then I have my palettes on my main desktop window, my main desktop monitor. And so I keep, and that's where I have all my layers and all my tools. So what I'm looking at is basically what you're looking at. What I'm looking at on my tablet is what I'm looking at on the main part of the stream there. And then everything else that I need, all my tools and swatches and layers, those are all on the monitor above me, so that's why I keep looking up and down. Some of you may recognize these lanterns here, or this whole room for that matter, as the bar scene I did a time lapse of that's on my YouTube page, where I go around and I light all these lanterns digitally light them, not actually lighting them, obviously. Lighting them with color, that's what I should say. And yeah, and I did a time lapse of that. It's on my YouTube page. So this is the same room, but it's now the next day. All the chairs are up, bar's not open yet, and there's some early morning daylight coming through. So those lights are all going to be off, but instead I'm going to have some lights coming in through the window. So I'm interested to see how that looks in the end. So here we have Cairn, our protagonist, Arcland Scavenger, her little robot friend Patterson, Bertrand, who's this alien dog-like creature here, and Rex, who is her normal dog, like dog, just dog. And then this is Bench, her friend who works at the bar and has something interesting to show her that she found in the basement of the bar. So that's where they're going right now. But I haven't drawn her sweater yet, so I'm not sure what color that's going to be. Try red for now.
You can only enter chat if you have a channel.
Yes.
Yes.
Possibly. I'm not sure.
It seems to be yes.
Huh. We'll look into that.
So you can only chat except for me.
Really?
Channel.
I think that's just normal.
Okay.
Questions from the sidelines. I think it's all good. All right. I don't usually shy away from touching up my inks. Oops. Wrong layer. I've come to terms with it. I'm not really a purist. At the end of the day, if it makes a nicer looking illustration, and I'm fine by it, within reason, because like obviously this isn't the most precise, this is all kind of wiggly, but that's alright, I can do that. What I can't quite live with is like, okay, that's a bit weird. I don't know, I get weirdly specific and then not specific. I guess my mood just changes. This is missing some line, so I'm going to go back and touch that. A lot of back and forth. I go up, I grab the wrong swatch, and then I come back down. So I've got swatches for all these main colors. This book has a very distinct, not very distinct, I shouldn't say that, but it has a semi-distinct palette, or a, I guess prescribed palette? I'm not sure what the best word is there. It has a palette, and so, generally speaking, if I need a yellow or a green or a turquoise or a red or this kind of grayish dark purple, I've got one that I use for most things, so it kind of has a consistency. Everything is coming from more or less the same colors. Sorry, just give me 1 second. Right. I think it's all good. Yeah, if there's anyone in the chat, let me know. Yeah, feel free to ask me questions or comments, of course, but yeah, let me know how it looks and sounds. This was way more complicated to set up than I thought, so I want to make sure it's working all right. Sometimes you don't see the mistakes till you start adding color. So, like, there's kind of this awkward plate missing here. So, I'm going to that. So yeah, it's definitely still messy, which I like. You know, I wanted something that was like pristine and perfect. Make it in vector, or take up photography or something else. The hand-drawn, sketchy look is definitely something I like, but it's all about looking intentional. It takes practice what does and doesn't look intentional. I definitely haven't mastered that. Mistakes that are good, mistakes that are bad. So like this toe here is all like cut off and gives him this weird kind of stumpy foot. So I want that to be a bit better. I guess I could just leave it like that. I don't know, give him actual toes. And the mitten hands, I think that's better. this. I need to touch this up. That's a bit too much. It's right here. Oh, actually, these need joints. Kind of like what I was talking about with the colors being consistent. I like to be consistent with my, I don't know what you call it, rules, visual themes. When I draw pipes, they always have these kind of accordion joints. Helps communicate that bend a bit better, I think, anyways. So these are missing. I forgot to ink them in. These have. I think I laid this on a bit thick. No need for that to stand up that much. So yeah, I seem to have pinned myself into a bit of a corner here. Looks like I was trying to, again, sometimes you don't notice these issues till you start coloring it and filling in these areas. Looks like I was starting a joint here, but then that doesn't finish, so I'm just gonna bend that right up there. I always forget when you zoom in so far, these details so insignificant. Sometimes. Alright, I'll just leave that. These steps too. All kinds of mistakes. These steps are not, as you can see here, the panel, they're like planks, not actual steps. These are these risers. looks better. Still got some little. Let's probably just walk away. Multiple details. What program? This is Photoshop. Thanks for asking. Thanks for joining us, Amy. Us. I keep saying us like I'm more than one person. Thanks for joining me. Yeah, this is Photoshop CS6. I'm not totally sold on her look. I mean, it's kind of insignificant in these panels where she's just kind of a blob in the distance, but here and in the next pages, she definitely has more of a presence. So I might change her colors if they start conflicting with the surrounding colors of the scene. Oops. That red hoodie. New white shirt. For a second there, I thought I gave her six toes. Now. Got the basement colors. Whoops. Got the basement colors pretty well good, but the upstairs colors don't quite have nailed down yet. Do the basement first. And I'll go back to my concept art and pull some swatches from that probably. See how this looks. So I know the floor. Oops. Come on. There we go. So I know this is green. Sure. But it's kind of grayish, mossy green. To the walls and floor green just for this shot. Because they're going down further, so it's kind of like a sub basement. I guess just one sub. Doesn't matter, maybe. Oh, sorry, yeah, I missed your question there. How do you decide on a color? Yeah, it takes a while. Concept art, yeah. So I did concept art for basically all the locations of this book. This bar scene being one of those locations. So I did standalone, just standalone illustrations, because this was a big book and it was very location oriented. So I wanted to nail down those environments and the colors of those environments, and it was a really great starting point. Well, with all the stages, but yeah, especially with the color stage, to nail down that final color feel of an environment. Deciding on the colors, I mean, that's something that, yeah, again, the concept art really helped with, figuring that out at the early stages and playing with different colors and how the different colors reflected different environments in the story and going from environment to environment, how those colors change, looking at that aesthetically and narratively, how those colors change the mood of the story. But it really comes down to with a lot of just playing around and then leaving it for a while and then coming back to it and seeing how you feel about it again. I'm actually gonna, now that you mentioned it, I'm gonna pull up that concept art. So I think I can use it right about now. This is it. No, this is the flat version. Ooh. No, that's the nighttime version. This might be it. Oh, that's super dark. Yeah, I think the colors are on the stream are coming up a bit darker than they should be. Yeah, that looks super dark. Just looking at the stream now. Yeah, okay. There's some crazy colors going on here. But underneath all the weirdness of this old Photoshop file, there is some good colors. There it is. All right. So there is the color layer from that initial concept art. You can see I used that brownish, light brownish color for the background here. What I don't have is that wood color. Pop that in. Oh, actually, you know what? I changed this color. Going back and forth, back and forth. Here. That's the colors I want. I believe that's the colors I want. Yeah, okay, so they're pretty light. Actually, I might have this in my swatches. We do. Okay, so that was all for naught. now I know what color that is. Yeah, that's a lot lighter. Enjoy is a weird word, but do I enjoy the process? Mostly. Yeah, I do. Coloring is definitely my favorite part of the process because, you know, the groundwork is laid out, and that's when you get to play around the most. So this is white. I'm putting it in there. I assume it's going to be right white. I might change it to light blue. But more often than not, if there's a bright light coming from a light source like a window or a lantern, you just want that white. You want that bright. Because you can layer in or add in some glow that shows the color of that light. If you just want that light to feel right, you need sort of a white base to it. Otherwise, you end up with this weird kind of dark glow, I find. Unless you're going for a really kind of saturated, unnatural glow. these guys are blue. These little, like, alien deer heads. I drew them in a previous chapter. I think they're blue. Almost got the groundwork laid out. So yeah, again, talking about how I choose colors, the concept art, playing around a lot with concept art in the beginning is what developed my palette for the book, this book, and how different visual things are colored similarly. So most times, you know, these pipes are the same color as here. So when I have a pipe to draw, I draw it this dark grayish purple. And boxes are usually kind of this grayish brown color. Got a couple different box paper colors to mix it up a bit. Add a new sheet here. Much better. How far into the comic am I? I'm about halfway, and yes, I have a timeline because I'm working with a publisher, Chi Zine, and their graphic novel group branching off of that, Chi Graphic, based out of Toronto, and it's due in October. So that's my timeline, which I am working basically all the time. All the time, every day, all day, to have it done for October. And then the final book is slated to release in early 2018. Another box here. That's too similar to the basement. On this shelf. Okay. Just fill that in solid. Maybe give it some grays in a bit. Thank you. I think that's all right. Probably tweak these flat colors. Well, I'll tweak them if I need to. So let's put in some shadows. Let's start defining this a bit better. Yeah, I'm going to shadow in all these lights. different brush texture here. Yeah, that'll help. Now, I think I'm going to start trying to bring some more atmospheric lighting into the scene. That may not be the right color. That might be. I think that's the look I'm looking for. No, I think this is getting there for sure. Lighting in this part needs some tweaking. I'm not sure if it just needs some new glows or if it needs more detailed color. Definitely getting there. Yes, it might just be something simple as that. So yeah, that might just about do it for this illustration. I think I'm going to add some highlights and glows. But I think it's basically there. Got the right tones and shadows in there. Overall vibe. And I think we might actually call that a night. I'm going to move on to some other work that's off screen for the evening. But we've been streaming for about 2 hours already. So thank you everyone who is watching right now. Everyone who came in and out over the course of the stream. And I hope you liked it. Definitely leave comments. For future streams, and what you found interesting about my process. Again, this is very new to me, so I'm not sure if anyone, what type of content people are interested in, and what aspects of my work people are most interested in that I can talk about or show more. Yeah, feedback is always welcome. So yeah. Thanks for watching. Have a good one.